You've probably heard it all before. Practice relentlessly, solve piles of problems, actively revise, you know, the usual suspects. But let's be real, do they really make you stand out from the crowd? Do they really turn you into a real beast in your subject? Not quite. Now, what if I told you there are three secret strategies your competition hasn't stumbled upon yet? So if you're ready to up your game, let's get started. First, let's take a trip back in time, all the way to the ancient Greeks, a period when extraordinary discoveries were as common as the olive trees. But before we disembark, let's conduct a little experiment, shall we? Picture a place, you know, like the back of your hand, perhaps your home, big up Northwest London, and imagine yourself walking through it. If you can, congratulations. You're already halfway there in using a powerful technique known as the method of loci. A bit like the loci you learn in your GCSE math. Suppose you're studying for a history exam. You would link each event with a different room or an object in a familiar location to you. Maybe use those different flavors of prime drink for each of Henry VIII's wives, then mentally organize those prime drinks in order to recall those events or facts that you have attached to each one. If you try your hardest, but you still can't see a thing, don't worry, I have other tips for you later. Skeptical you might be, look no further than the World Memory Championships. These guys are the real bad mans of memory, so you can't even question their methodology. Contestants there regularly use the method of loci to remember huge amounts of information, like 630 random digits in just 5 minutes. And they don't just remember this information for a few minutes, they retain it for hours, even days. And let's not forget about this guy. Our spatial memory, the kind of memory we use when we imagine moving through a location, is especially strong. We're wired to remember locations and routes. It's an extraordinary advantage that we can use to our benefit when studying. It's not magic, it's a tool. And like any tool, it becomes more effective the more you practice with it. Next up is a concept known as fast and slow thinking. Ever come across this one? It's the very definition of revising smarter, not harder, popularized by Daniel Kahneman, a Nobel Memorial Prize winner for the economic sciences. Imagine two gears in your brain. The fast gear, which operates intuitively, almost like a reflex, which is your primal, so not so smart or conscious brain. It's like when you catch a ball thrown at you without consciously thinking about it. Oh! Then there's the slow gear, which is more deliberate, like solving a challenging maths problem. It's meticulous, smarter, conscious, calculated, but can sometimes make learning feel like a chore. While studying, we often default to our slow thinking, which can be energy draining. What if we could bring the fast thinking gear and make it more instinctive and dynamic? By incorporating a variety in your study patterns, switching between subjects, changing up question types, introducing unexpected elements, you engage your fast thinking system, make your revision feel less tedious and more interactive. Lastly, remember the amygdala from your science class? That's your brain's emotion center. What if I told you you could utilize the power of your amygdala to supercharge your memory? That's right, when there's an activity in your amygdala, your memorization skills dramatically improve. Infuse a dash of emotion into your study sessions. Make it competitive. Get yourself fired up before or during your revision with a race against your friends or siblings. And before I let you go, here's a bonus nugget, the serial position effect. The serial position effect theorizes that you remember the first and last thing you encounter most over the things you've encountered towards the middle. Now, if you have a regular order of subjects or topics you revise, you're really hindering your progress. So cover all of your bases and shake up that order. Guys, you're not aiming to pass, you're aiming to be the best. Leave a like on this video for more content like this. Good luck with your exams. Peace.